The Decadence of Our Souls is a story about how we can become better human beings through perpetual and continual cleaning, mental, spiritual, and physical. It's a story about children and elephants, children which are born into an environment, in a pristine environment, in a jungle, in the middle of nowhere, where the elephants are their teachers, and they are trying to bring them to a different level of spirituality, back to their creator, which in this case is called the one who created all. They have their own books from where they learn how to better themselves. And also on the other side is the decadent world, which is focused only on drugs, sex, and cheap entertainment. The moment one of the children is being kidnapped and taken to this world who has no, who believes in nothing, the child is trying to, who in fact is a special soul, is called an orange soul, he's trying to change the people he's coming in contact with. And it's a continued battle between good and evil, and if he is successful or not on changing them. In the end, the one who created all has a way out for everyone by giving them the chance to uplift their souls, understand the main goal of life, the happiness in life, and maybe later on bring them back better human beings. The whole process took about 2.5 years, and it started in fact 30 years ago when I had the idea about what happens if all souls will be lifted up and there will be no human beings left on Earth. But recently I received a photograph done by Gregory Colbert, who is a well-known Canadian photographer specialized in wildlife. And the photograph depicted a kneeled child reading in front of or reading to a kneeled elephant. And I start imagining what's the connection between these two entities, how they react, what's the information they are exchanging. And I start jotting down ideas, which in the end generated the first chapter, and then everything rolled from there into the I think, amazing novel. I also had the chance to have a great team around me. My son created the front cover illustration. Nina Montano was my editor, and she's well versed in this process. In the end, I've decided to self-publish, because the message of the book was too important to wait for maybe 2, maybe 3 years to go through a traditional publishing process. Right before starting the book, I got involved in Kriya Yoga, which was initiated by Paramahansa Yogananda under the Self-Realization Fellowship movement. And after reading Autobiography of a Yogi, Second Coming of Christ, which explains the the hidden lessons behind the Second Testament, and also the teachings behind Bhagavad Gita, I realized that I have to change myself, and this is one way to reach that state of bliss and enlightenment. Hopefully we all gonna come to the conclusion that we are all the same, and yes, we are individuals, but our structure, organic structure, is the same, our brain is the same, everything is the same, we have the same creator, even if we choose to go separate path in terms of religion or spirituality. The creator is the same, and the way we're going to get to a state of enlightenment could be different, but doesn't mean that we have to point fingers and say that you are bad, or I am better than you, or you know, you have to come my way, otherwise there is no way you're going to reach that state of bliss. So that's a big mistake, which is perpetuated by political leaders, by religious leaders. I really don't know where we're going to end up if we don't realize that we have to unite in the way of being better human beings and not and, and stop going after the bone, because the bone is has no meat on it anymore. It's just a dry bone.
What's the next project?
My next project is about water. I really hope to have another good message to portray in my next novel, because water is an amazing medium which we have no understanding, I think, how flexible and how capable of storing information, transmitting information. Could be a healing medium as well, and we really have to take care of it because it's a scarce medium right now.
Okay.
Thank you.
I said the last
one. Yeah, merci.